Hello everyone, I'm Teng Yuan Zhang from Baidu Mini App Team. Today, my talk is about the new generation web platform, the Mini App. Today's agenda, I've introduced the Mini App user cases and scenarios, and talking about some technical features and architectures. And then, I will show you our alliance development experience. I hope it can help for you. You know that in the last 5 years, the native apps and HTML5 website has been the game stage. And the stretching to find the balance in performance, user experience, and development flexibility. And now I introduce the Mini App for you. Let me show you some use cases of Mini App. In nowadays China, more and more content players build their mini apps besides their native apps. It gets great help to expanding the user visitors and out of their platform already headed, such as the news, the medias, and the live information platforms. The user can get the useful mini apps from search engine and information flows in China. And actually, more and more online shopping companies build their business at the mini app platform. Maybe you know that the Chinese company named Pinduoduo and VIP Shop, they made the great success in the mini app ecosystem. Based on the offline user scenario, user can use the scan QR code to launch any mini apps. It is easy to offer the mini app and to build to take the offline bill and the shopping at the restaurants or the shopping malls. And there was also some expressed the user cases. In addition about the bot point, Chinese government are providing informations and surveys for mini app to build the more efficiency online working. And back to into the mini app technology. And you can see the left video. This is a demo for developers. It contains a large number of rich APIs, components, and framework capabilities. And the mini app, this is easy for developer to build a mini app easily. And you know that the mini app is a cross-platform solutions. It means once built and run anywhere, it can it is less development cost. And the mini app contains the offline and the caching functions. It makes the mini app has the offline experience and it can run in the background. Let me briefly introduce the development process to build the mini app program. The first, the mini app developer used the mini app DSL, domain specific language, to write the layout and the logic code, and then packaging it with developing tools with supplier and publishing to the mini app packaging manager service. We called it the PMS services. And when user click the mini app schema URL on the HTML5 page, and mini app runtime start to prepare and request the PMS service for the manifest field. The mini app manifest field contains the meta information and the package download URL. When the runtime fetching the package field, and it will be unzipped and caching in the local file system. And then it can be load or reload and start the mini app. The left figure shows the demo to build the mini app. What is a mini app schema? This is an example of a mini app schema. The schema is described which mini which app to process its URL to open the mini app from the schema description part. And the mini app APPK decided which mini app want to open. The mini app APPK is unique for every published mini app. And the path and the query part is similar with the URI scheme standard relations and which distinguish which page to load and what the parameters. As I have said, the mini app URI scheme distinguish which mini app to launch, and the mini app runtime is responsibility to load this code and run the user interfaces. You can see the figure, and mini app runtime framework contains two layers, the JS logic layer, the JS runtime layer, and the native runtime layer. The JS runtime layer is the top layer of developer-based library. The mini app code will deal with this layer directly, and the JS runtime layer is responsible for two things. One is start to unload the render code and expose the client-side capabilities and providing the native functions calls and run the mini app logic code. And the next layer is the native runtime layer. It contains the package managers part and the page stack managing part, and support the implement of APIs via the JS bridge technology. You can see that every mini app can run in the single process beside the user agent processes. It is a facility for the every user agent to integrate it, mini app runtime. Let me introduce the mini app JavaScript runtime. The JavaScript runtime is the core of the mini app. This contains the two part of the runtime containers. The one is the render containers. Another is the logic containers. The render containers use the WebView thread to render and interact with user behaviors. In general, the render layout is the WebView, and it can be the other render engine. And the logical container is responsible for executing the JS files, which can be implemented in two ways. The WebView or the V8 JavaScript engine. The V8 JavaScript engine is the more efficient. The communication mechanism is based on the native message buses. And the absolute render and the layout is for the better performance. You can see this left figure. It shows how the runtime prepare for the mini app starting. And the first, when the user to clicks the mini app's URI scheme to start the mini app, the runtime will start prepare and download the package file. And then the logic thread and the render thread now start working. The render thread will load the render code like the CSS file and the HTML file converted by the DSL language. And the logic layer will load some libraries and plugins and load the logic code, the JS files. And when the render thread has the first containful paint, it will interact with the logic layer. Logic layer will run the mini app code to fetching the data from server, and then use the set data interface to have to paint the render thread. You can see the logic thread and the render thread is isolated, and the logic thread cannot operate the DOM and ABOM directly. It is a help for security. And the logic layer, logic thread in the single thread, and it will not affect or slowing down the render thread to load the pages. And another benefit is this is and help for developer to get the life cycle between the different pages in the same way. And let's talk about the performance and how to measure the media performance. Like the website performance, media performance also uses this key metrics to measure the performance. And the first is first pin time. You can see that this picture. And after mini app is launched, the login precise starts. You can see the top bar and the bottom bar is displayed. And this time is the first pin. And the first content pin means that when the user start, when the page start loading, the mini app code, you can see that the search bar has been displayed to the user. This is the first content pin time. And the most important is the first meaningful pin. It measures when the primary content of the page is visible to users. It also it usually to load the service data and render it to the users in the window. And the time to interact the show that all the element has been pulled down and displayed, and the user can interact all of the whole window in this time. And next, I will show you the whole picture of the mini app architecture. The architecture contains two layers, developer layers and the runtime layers. As I have said, the mini app developer need to get the restrictions and decide what are the functions they need and what are the function scope they need, and set the version and operating and distribution settings. And they can use the developing tools to build and to debug the mini app, then publishing it to the packaging deployment. Then when it passed the audience, and the developer can decide when to release or how to release it. And the runtime layer have three parts, the library layer and the porting layer and the controller layer. The library layer contains supplies many components like the web components, native components such as maps, videos, canvas, and host capabilities, and it has many APIs such as get send request network APIs or set storage APIs or get location APIs. It contains the basic libraries for the mini app running code. And the port layer decide when the different user agent, they can decide the way what interface and what functions they want to implement and to supply the support for the their different mini app environment. And the last part is the controller and the dependency layer. It is a runtime controller part. It contains the routers, lifecycles, precise, and app contents, and permission management. And the dependency, it contains the hardware libraries, such as media, webkit, and maps, cameras, and some user count of fundamental capabilities such as payment, account, or AI libraries. And I will introduce our runtime adapter layer. And you know that the mini app is the open ecosystem, and we have the mini app runtime SDK. When different user agent integrate our SDK, they can get the package fetching and the page statement functions. And the host apps or user agent, they can customize which APIs or which special functions they want to implement in their environment. And this was the porting layer. And after the host integrate our framework, it must use the CTS or CTS test to ensure the quality of runtime. So this, I will show you our Alliance development appearance. You can see that picture. We have integrated our SDK in many super apps, such as HEE, Xiaohongshu, and the right video is the user case of HEE apps. HEE apps is a video streaming video apps, and it can user can use the HEE apps and find the expanding video contents from different mini apps. And they can view the different contents, video contents, and share it to their friends and have to interact with the other functions in the mini app. It is a combine of the mini app and the app's experience to user. And besides this, the mini apps platform has built-in such as vehicle systems and IoT devices and OIs and the customer systems. It combines the different experience to the Orange systems. And we are working with WCC to expanding more open mini app ecosystem. We hope any mini app program can truly run anywhere between the different vendors. So we hope you can join with us and building the more international mini app ecosystem. So I hope our experience can help you. Thank you.